So this is our second topic, the second activity. As I told you that we have to discuss three activities after autotrophic nutrition, which are mentioned in your NCRT also. So this second activity is to prove that CO2 is necessary for photosynthesis. So how you are going to write or perform this activity? Here, as you can see, that we have taken two plants. One plant I have named it as a test plant and one is the control plant. Control is usually that plant which is given everything: sunlight, water, chlorophyll, CO2, means all conditions or all things required by plant is given to this. So this is our control. Now that plant in which we are going to perform experiment, that is called our test plant. Here, as you can see, sunlight is given to it, water we are providing, chlorophyll we are giving, but no CO2 is given to this plant, right? So that is the difference between control and test plant. So we are going to compare our result, test plant and control plant, that how CO2 affect the process of photosynthesis. Now what you have to do, take two healthy potted plants, as you can see, almost of same size. We have to take two healthy potted plants, keep them in dark room for 3 days. I already explained in my previous video that what is the purpose to keep them in dark room for 3 days, that is for the destarching, to remove the complete starch. Then keep them in sunlight, that step is same, for 6 hours. So here we are doing some additional thing, that we are keeping KOH potassium hydroxide or NaOH pellets near. Pellets is like the small, you can say small KOH pellets, basically small tablets near to our test plant. What is the reason to keep KOH? Because KOH absorb complete carbon dioxide, right? So as you can see in this diagram, when we are keeping our plant in 6 hours in the sunlight, then we have placed KOH or NaOH pellet in our test plant. In control plant, we are not keeping anything. Covered both the plants with the this is bell jar. Why we are covering this? We are covering this to ensure that our experiment setup is airtight. Now what you have to do in our next step, pluck a leaf from each of the plant, from this and from this, from test and control plant. Perform starch test. As you know, that starch test is performed by using iodine. So perform starch test. After performing starch test, it is noticed that in this plant, that is our test plant, there was no change in color. No change in color was observed. Matlab, means that if starch was there, then it should turn into blue and black color. But here in control plant, as all factors we were providing CO2 also, so there the plant has changed its color, it turned into blue black complex, right? So it has no reaction with iodine, this plant has no reaction with iodine. So what is proved from here? That in test plant, as there was no CO2 was there, so no process of photosynthesis. And in other plant, all the conditions were there, it react with iodine, and because starch was there, so it shows that CO2 is necessary for photosynthesis. The main thing you have to understand is, if plant is making doing photosynthesis, starch will be there, starch react with iodine, and your leaf color will change, which will confirm the presence of starch and or absence of starch. And photosynthesis only help to form the glucose, and glucose is transported in the form of sucrose and stored in the form of starch. So that was our second activity. So now the third and last activity after autotrophic nutrition, and after this we were able to finish our first topic. So sunlight is essential to perform photosynthesis. As we say, carbon dioxide, water, sunlight, these are the essential elements for the process photosynthesis. So what we are going to do, as from after two activities, now you have got the idea that what is the purpose of all these activities. Take a plant with destarched leaves. I'm not going to explain here now in complete detail, because as you know that destarched means you are keeping your plant in dark for 3 days and removing the complete starch from it. Wrap one of its leaves with black paper. You have taken a plant and its all leaves are green, but one you have selected one of the green leaf and then covered it with dark black paper. Now fix this black paper on the leaf with some clips so that the light should not at all enter in on this dark spot. So place this plant in sunlight for few hours, approximately 6 hours, then test the leaf that is covered by the black paper. So you have to plug this leaf, and we are going to test it for the presence of starch by using which solution? Iodine solution. So it was observed that only parts of leaf which were exposed to light, they will turn into blue and black, which indicates the presence of starch, means photosynthesis is performing by the leaves only in those areas where sunlight was there. And other portion which was covered with black paper, that does not or did not show its change into blue-black color after starch test. As you can see this, that here we covered this area. So here this area only, it did not show the change in color, and other area, other part of the leaf showed the change. So it is showed what you are confirmed now, that starch is formed only at the parts where sunlight falls. So it is very clear from this experiment that sunlight is compulsory for the formation of starch, and starch is formed by process of photosynthesis. So here we are finished with our first topic of life process. Just first subtopic I will say, that is the autotrophic nutrition. See you till the next video.